is filled with love and grace. From the peaceful embers glow, blessed Yuletide spirits grow.
Tell you a story. It's about Christmas. Oh, it's not the usual Christmas story. This is a scary one, all about ghosts. It was London on a cold and bitter morning, the day before Christmas, and I, Ebenezer Scrooge, was walking to my counting house.
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas to one and all!
Give a penny for the poor. Penny for the poor.
December 24th. Just 7 years ago today, my partner, Jacob Marley, died. Old Marley. He robbed the widows, stole from the orphans, swindled the poor. They don't make men like Marley anymore. In his will, he left me enough money to pay for his tombstone. And I had him buried at sea. Oh, he'd have been proud of me. I was greeted by my faithful clerk, Bob Cratchit.
Good morning, Mr. Scrooge.
Cratchit, what are you doing with that piece of coal in your hand?
I was going to put it in the stove.
You put a piece of coal in the stove last week. What are you trying to do? Raise tomatoes?
No, I was just trying to thaw out the ink.
Bah! Get on with your work.
Mr. Scrooge, tomorrow is Christmas, and I was wondering if I could have half a day off.
Christmas, eh? Well, I suppose so. But I'll dock you half a day's pay. Now, let's see. I'll pay you 2 shillings a day.
2 shillings and a halfpenny, sir.
Oh, yes. I gave you that raise 3 years ago.
Yes, sir, when I started doing your laundry.
All right, Cratchit. Get busy while I go over my books. Oh, and here. Here's another bundle of shirts for you.
Yes, sir.
Let's see. Macduff owes me. I owe MacDougal. Yuck. Money, money, money.
The only thing that counts with me is money. The only thing I'm counting on is cash. The happiest time of day is when I put my coins away, lock 'em up, bolt the door and dream about my stash. As a philanthropic fella, I'm a failure, but as a miser, I'm a smash. The only thing that counts for me is M-O-N-E-Y, you see. The only thing I'm counting on is cash.
The only thing that counts with him is money.
Money!
The only thing he's counting on is gold. Nobody could exceed this individual for greed.
Scrooge is cheap, what a creep!
His heart is really cold.
They tell you that you cannot buy contentment.
Oh, sorry.
But that philosophy is trash.
I didn't mean it.
The only thing that counts with me is M-O-N-E-Y, you see. The only thing I'm counting on is cash.
Cash.
Money.
Christmas to you, Master Fred.
Well, yes, my Uncle Scrooge. I ain't going to invite Uncle Dinner.
Who's there?
Oh, nephew, what do you want? Tis a work day, you know.
Merry Christmas, Uncle Scrooge.
Humbug, I say. Bah, humbug. I'll tell you what Christmas is. It's just another work day. And any jackanapes who thinks else should be boiled in his own pudding.
Oh, but Mr. Scrooge, is it your intent to work on Christmas?
Right. You keep Christmas in your way, and I'll keep it in mine.
Ah, come on.
But, sir, Christmas is a time of year for giving, a time to be charitable, a time to be with one's family.
I say bah humbug.
I don't care. I say Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Well said, Master Fred.
Cratchit, what are you doing?
Trying to keep my hands warm, sir.
And what are you doing here, nephew?
I've come to invite you to Christmas dinner.
Oh. I suppose you're going to have a plump goose with chestnut dressing.
Yes.
And will you have plum pudding and lemon sauce?
That is.
With roast squab and pickled raisins?
Yes, yes.
And candied fruits with spiced sugar cakes?
Yes, will you come?
You daft man, you know I can't eat that stuff. Out, out, out!
But, sir, Master Fred has brought us a Christmas wreath. May I hang it on our door?
You do, and I'll hang one on you.
Here's your wreath, and a Merry Christmas.
And here's your wreath back. And bah humbug.
Merry Christmas.
And a bah humbug to you.
That boy Fred, always so full of forgiveness and love.
Yes, he always was a little weird. I'll tell you how Christmas ought to be. Everybody ought to get up early. But not to see the presents neath the tree. If Christmas cheer they're looking for, a cup of tea's enough to pour. That's the way Christmas ought to be. How about a Christmas stroll this morning? A walk to work is healthy, all agree. Let's cut out this Good Neighbor Day and add another Labor Day. That's the way Christmas ought to be. Bah, humbug! Bah, humbug! No Christmas carols for me. Bah, humbug! That's my song, and I'll sing it happily. Bah, 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 humbug! Cratchit! Is all this talk about a day off? Employees think so inconsistently. If they don't work on Christmas Day, then we shall take it from their pay. That's the way Christmas ought to be.
Ooh! Customers, I'll handle this, Cratchit. Yes, what can I do for you two gentlemen?
Sir, we are soliciting funds for the indigent and destitute.
For the what? We're collecting for the poor. Oh, aha. Well, you realize if you give money to the poor, they won't be poor anymore, will they?
Well,
And if they're not poor anymore, then you won't have to raise money for them anymore.
Well, I suppose.
And if you don't have to raise money for them anymore, then you would be out of a job. Oh, please, gentlemen, don't ask me to put you out of a job, not on Christmas Eve.
Oh, we wouldn't do that, Mr. Scrooge.
All right, both of you, out, out, out! And take your pot and your pennies for the poor with you! What's the world coming to, Cratchit? You work all your life to get money, and people want you to give it away. What time is it?
2 minutes till closing time, sir.
Well, never mind working those 2 minutes. You may go now.
Oh, thank you, sir. You are so very kind.
Never mind that mushy stuff. Just go. Now you can come in 2 minutes early the day after Christmas to make up the time.
I will, sir. And a bah humbug to, a Merry Christmas to you, sir.
At length, the hour for shutting my counting house arrived. And with an ill will, I put on my greatcoat and carefully locked the door. Outside, fog and darkness had set in, and it was bitter cold. As I walked the crowded street, I took no notice of the merry people hurrying home to their loved ones.
Wait your way for a penny, sir?
I'm used to this fog, you beggar. I can find my own way. And find my way I did, to my usual melancholy tavern, to order my even more melancholy supper. Upon finishing my meager repast, I made my way through the fog to my gloomy suite of rooms. Reaching the dark yard, something strange met my eye. It was the door knocker.
Oh!
For a moment, the door knocker took on the face of my late partner, Jacob Marley. I pinched his nose.
Oh! That's smart.
No, that can't be. Door knockers don't speak. It's simply a figment of my imagination. It's a fignation of my fagum. Bah! Humbug! I was understandably shaken by this ghostly vision. As I walked upstairs, I heard what seemed to be footsteps close behind me. They seemed to be dragging something. Chains, it would appear. No, no, it's imagination. Yes, a fagment of Finch. Figgles of my fadges. Oh, here's the door. I hurried into my room and shut the door. And locked it. And chained it. And bolted it. Ah. Who is it?
Ooh.
Unhindered by the heavy door, the chain, the locks, and the bolts, the ghost of Jacob Marley passed into the room before my frightened eyes. A cold chill enveloped my whole body. My teeth began to chatter. My knees began to knock. And my eyes popped.
Now that you finished the number, I'd like to talk to you.
What do you want of me? Who are you?
Ask me not who I am. Ask me who I was.
Okay, who was you?
Scrooge, don't you recognize me? Your old partner, Jacob Marley.
Jacob Marley? It is you. But you're a ghost. I can see right through you. But then I always could. And those chains. Why are you wearing those chains?
I don't know. Chains are in this year.
But Jacob, what is it you want of me?
I have an important message for you, Scrooge. You know, when I was alive, I robbed the widows and stole from the orphans and swindled the poor.
Yes, and all in the same day. Oh, you had class, Jacob, class.
Yes. But I was wrong, Ebenezer. I was so wrong. I was a penny pincher. I saved every coin. I lived on bread and water, never tenderloin. I robbed and rooked my neighbors. To kids I was unkind. And when I needed pencils, I stole them from the blind. Alas, it's much too late for me, Ebenezer. 'Cause I didn't find out in time that being tight is not alright. Now I must wear these chains at night. That's why I'm singing you the song. Being tight is not alright, Ebenezer. It's all wrong. So stop and take a look now before it's too late. For when you die, your chains will be a mighty heavy weight. So when the spirit beckons, better do as you are told. Remember, Ebenezer, you're getting very old. It may not be too late for you, Ebenezer, if you'll only find out in time that being tight is not all right. You needn't wear these chains at night. That's why I'm a-singing you this song. Being tight is not all right. It's all wrong.
Gosh.
And so, as a punishment, Ebenezer, I'm forced to carry these heavy chains throughout eternity. Maybe even longer. And they're very uncomfortable, double. And there's no hope. I'm doomed. Doomed! And the same thing can happen to you, Ebenezer Scrooge.
No, no, it can't. It mustn't. Help me, Jacob. What can I do?
Gosh, I don't know. Oh, tonight you will be visited by three spirits, ghosts. Listen to them, do what they say, or your chains will be heavier than mine.
But, Jacob, tell me why.
I gotta go now. These chains are killing me. Ooh, ow, eesh.
All right, Marley. Look, careful where you're going. Watch out for that first.
Whoa!
step.
I was much shaken by this ghostly vision as I tried to go to sleep. It seemed I'd been abed only a moment when the clock started to strike the hour.
What? Well, it's about time. Haven't got all night, you know.
Who are you?
Why, I'm the ghost of Christmas past.
Oh, I thought you'd be taller.
Listen, Scrooge. If men were measured by kindness, you'd be no bigger than a speck of dust.
Kindness is of little use in this world.
You didn't always think so. Come on, Scrooge. It's time to go.
Then go.
Spirit! What are you doing?
We're gonna visit your past.
I'm not going out there. I'll fall.
Just hold on. Whoop! Not too tight now.
And with that, we were through the window and flying over the darkened city.
Spirit! Look out!
What's wrong, Scrooge? I thought you enjoyed looking down on the world.
Suddenly it was light, and then I saw something I remembered from a long time ago. As I peered through the window, I beheld a Christmas party in progress.
Spirit, I believe I know this place. Yes, it's old Fezziwig's. I couldn't have worked for a kinder man. Why, it's old Fezziwig himself, and all of my very dearest friends. And that shy lad in the corner, that's me.
Yes, that was before you became a miserable miser, consumed by greed.
Well, nobody's perfect. And there's lovely Isabel.
Ebenezer. Ebenezer.
Yes, Isabel?
My eyes are closed, my lips are puckered, and I'm standing under the mistletoe.
You're also standing on my foot.
Oh, what a merry Christmas this is under the mistletoe. Candlelight and kids and kisses warm from the fire's glow. Pretty presents gaily wrapped there under the Christmas tree. What a happy holiday for you. Moment last a lifetime, or at least till the snowman melts. Soon the evening will be over under the mistletoe. Let us dance the Christmas waltz before it's time to go. Years from now I'll still recall the night so long ago, when a Christmas kiss you gave to me under the mistletoe.
I remember how much I was in love with her.
In 10 years' time, you learn to love something else.
Why, it's my counting house. 9,972. 9,000...
Ebenezer!
Yes, Isabel, what can I do for you?
For years I've had this honeymoon cottage, Ebenezer. I've been waiting for you to keep your promise to marry me. Now I must know. Have you made your decision?
I have. Your last payment on the cottage was 7 minutes late. I'm foreclosing the mortgage.
You loved your gold more than that precious creature, and you lost her forever.
Please, Spirit, I can no longer bear these memories. Take me home.
Remember, Scrooge, you fashioned these memories yourself. Yourself, 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 yourself.
And in a flash, I was back in my bed. Och, I thought, 'twas but a dream. Here it was past 2 o'clock, and no spirit had appeared. There was no ghost. No Christmas past. The whole thing had been a bad nightmare. But then I became aware of a huge shadow appearing in my room. Suddenly, the room became light. And there was a giant of a man.
I'm sorry I'm late, but I had a problem with a little boy named Jack. What that kid did with a beanstalk, you wouldn't believe.
I had never seen a bigger man or a fatter man.
Have you ever seen a fatter ghost than me? I'm so fat
How fat are you?
I'm so fat that when I'm in the room, no matter where you look, I am. I am the spirit of Christmas present.
What do you do?
Don't ask me what I do. Ask me what I did.
Okay. What did you did?
I have filled the room with all of the good things that you have withheld from your fellow man. Look.
Spilling out of a huge cornucopia were all manner of exotic foods. Suckling pigs, turkeys, wreaths of sausages, fruitcakes, mince pies, and a prune Danish to go. As I reached for a corned beef on rye, the giant stopped me.
We have no time for that now. We have a long way to travel, and we must fly. Take hold of my robe. Not back there, unless you want to fly tourist.
I took hold of his robe, and we were off. In a moment, we were at Bob Cratchit's humble cottage. Looking through the window, we beheld the family seated around the dinner table. On Bob's right was his son, Tiny Tim.
What is Cratchit doing? Carving a canary?
What would you expect with the meager wage you bestow upon him? 2 shillings a day?
2 shillings and a halfpenny. He does my laundry.
Listen, Ebenezer Scrooge. Listen.
Don't eat yet, my dear family. There's more to come. On top of this marvelous bird, we have 1 raisin each.
Ooh!
1/2 walnut.
Ah!
2 grapes.
Ooh! Ah!
Now, before we start, let's not forget the man who made this glorious feast possible, Mr. Ebenezer Scrooge.
Please, not when we're eating.
Dear wife, this is the season of goodwill to men. What do you say, Tiny Tim?
I say thank you, Mr. Scrooge, and God bless us, everyone.
That's right. You see, we've got a Christmas tree. Well, it's just as small as a holly sprig, but we got a goose, and it's as tiny as a sparrow.
But we have love, we have love.
Well, I guess there won't be any pretty toys to cheer our little girls and boys, because, well, our Christmas budget, it's much too narrow.
But we have love, we have love.
They are blessing you, Ebenezer Scrooge. You, who have supplied them with such a paltry fare.
Oh, but surely they have more food than that. Look, look at that huge pot boiling on the stove.
Yeah, that's your laundry.
We don't have everything we want, but we have all we need. Our stockings may be empty, but our hearts are full indeed.
Oh, yes, we've got a pudding. Unfortunately, it's smaller than a single plum. But today, we'll share with one another.
We'll share our love. We have love.
Oh.
I turned to the spirit. He was gone.
Spirit, where are you? Don't go. You must tell me about Tim.
What's wrong with that kind lad?
Don't go!
Who are you? Are you the ghost of Christmas future?
I feared this specter more than all the others, for he was the ghost of the future, the spirit of things to come. We were back at the Cratchit house, but what a change. No longer were there happy songs coming from within. Looking through the window, I saw the family gathered around the table as before. But now, the chair on Bob Cratchit's right was empty. Tiny Tim was gone.
Spirit of the future, what does this mean? No, no, I didn't want this to be. I wanted Tiny Tim to get well. That sweet, darling boy.
I now found myself in a churchyard, where two gravediggers were engaged in their ghoulish occupation.
That does it.
Tamp it down tight, Charlie.
You know, Harold, I never saw a funeral like this one.
Right. There was nobody about. No mourners, no friends, no one to shed a tear or bid him farewell.
Spirit, whose lonely grave is this?
Why, yours, Ebenezer. The richest man in the cemetery.
No, no, I don't want my life to end this way. Not another chance. The spirits of Christmas past, present, and future shall live within me.
Spirit, I'll change my ways. No, no, no. I'll change.
Where am I? I'm back in my own bed. And those bells. It must be. It is. It's Christmas morning. Oh, I want to hear those beautiful bells. I want to see the morning. Yes, I can be a new man. I will honor Christmas in my heart and keep it all the year. Merry Christmas, everybody. What a glorious Christmas morning.
What a glorious Christmas morning. What a day this is going to be. All over the world the Christmas bells ring out the happiest of Noels. Let's all share this timely thought. It's better to give than receive. What a glorious Christmas morning after our Christmas Eve. Dinner will be a winner with turkey, the star of the day. Then a big plum pudding to top it off. Is it any wonder we say? What a glorious Christmas morning, very happiest day of the year, when children's eyes have a special glow from joy that only a child can know. Oh, St. Nick has come to call, surprises up his sleeve. What a glorious Christmas morning after our Christmas Eve.
Oh, what a wonderful day. Oh, there's so much to do. Oh, so much to do.
Merry Christmas to one and all. Oh, well, bless me. Good morning, gentlemen. I've something for you.
20 gold sovereigns? Oh, no!
Not enough? Well, all right. 50 gold sovereigns.
Really, Mr. Scrooge, it's...
Still not enough. Aye, you drive a hard bargain. Here you are. 100 gold pieces. And not a penny more. Not a penny more.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Scrooge. Thank you. And a Merry Christmas to you.
I went to the butcher's shop and bought the biggest turkey I could get. Then, with my arms laden with presents, I took myself to the Cratchit cottage.
Why, Mr. Scrooge, what...
I came to tell you, bah humbug. And to wish you and your family a Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Mr. Scrooge? Oh, yes, Merry Christmas. Everyone, look who's here. It's Mr. Scrooge.
Yes, it's Mr. Scrooge. And I've brought Christmas presents for you and all the children.
Oh!
And something for Mrs. Cratchit, too.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Scrooge.
But, Mr. Scrooge, I don't understand.
What do you mean you don't understand? Why, only yesterday you told me Christmas was a time for giving. Well, now I'll tell you what Christmas is. Tis a time that once a year, men and women seem by one consent to open their shut-up hearts freely and celebrate the joy of the season.
Mr. Scrooge, oh, we're awful glad to see you. Come on and sit for a while by the tree. Take off your hat and coat and we'll light a fire and warm the house.
Ah, this is the way Christmas ought to be.
It is?
I want to thank you for this lovely welcome.
Oh, you're welcome.
I've learned my lesson well, as you can see. At Christmas time, I've missed so much the love of friends, the family touch. This is the way Christmas ought to be.
Oh, I can't believe it.
Bah, humbug. Bah, humbug. No more of that for me. I've got a brand new song, and I'll sing it happily. Merry, merry, merry Christmas.
Merry, merry, merry Christmas.
So let the bells ring out the Christmas message, and let the carolers sing so merrily.
Now, quoting from Bob Cratchit's son, God bless us, each and every one.
This is the way Christmas ought to be. This is the way,
this is the way
Christmas ought to be.
I just can't believe it.
The next morning, I was early at my counting house. Oh, I was early there. As early as Bob Cratchit was late. Well, Cratchit.
Good morning, Mr. Scrooge.
Good morning, indeed. You're late, Cratchit. You're 18 minutes late. Have you a guess at what I'm going to do?
You're going to discharge me, sir?
No, I'm going to give you a raise.
A what?
Fetch the coal scuttle, build the fire, warm the counting house. The warmth of Christmas love will dwell in this place every day of the year. Let it be said that no one will ever keep Christmas as well as Ebenezer Scrooge.
Christmas!